pleasant good morning to the brethren, and good morning to our first time viewers. Welcome to CUREP Pentecostal Empowerment Ministries International. We are happy to have you. We continue with our theme, Empowered by His Spirit, Growing to Greatness. And as such, we want to read Romans chapter 8, verse 15 to 17, and Hebrews chapter 12, from verse 25 to 29. Shall we read together? Romans chapter 8, let's take it up from verse 15, and it reads, "For ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. If so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together." And our second reading is taken from Hebrews chapter 12, and let's take it up from verse 25, and it reads, "See that ye refuse not him that speaketh. For if they escape not who refused him that spake on it, much more shall not we escape if we turn away from him that speaketh from heaven, whose voice then shook the earth, but now he hath promised, saying, Yet once more, I shake not the earth only, but also heaven. And this word, yet once more, signifieth the removing of those things that are shaken, as of things that are made, that those things which cannot be shaken may remain. Wherefore, we receiving a kingdom which cannot be moved, let us have grace, whereby we may serve God acceptable with reverence and godly fear. For our God is a consuming fire." Thank you, Lord, for your word. Let us pray. Almighty God, creator of the ends of the earth, we give you all the honor, all the glory, all the praise. God, there is none like you, none to be compared to you, none in heaven, none in the earth, none beneath the earth. We commit this morning service into your hand, God. Let your name be glorified. We pray, O God, for that person who might be stressed out at this point in time. We pray that they will receive your peace, peace of mind. God, that person that needs healing right now, someone might be infected with this virus. We claim your healing for them right now in the name of Jesus. God, by your stripes, we are healed. And we receive your healing now. We send that word of healing in Jesus' name. I pray that you will give that person that deliverance, that person whoever needs it right now. We send your word to deliver, to set free in the name of Jesus. We pray for that individual who needs salvation. Let your word go forward with power today, God. Minister unto our pastor as he brings forward your word. Let it touch lives today, O God. We come against every blockage of the enemy right now. We rebuke you, Satan. We set those minds free to hear and to receive the good news of the gospel. God, we lift up our worship team, oh God. Let that song that goes forward, let it minister unto those hearers, oh God. The band as they play, oh God, let that song go forward and minister unto those that hear, oh God. So we commit this entire service into your hand. Let your name be glorified. God, we pray for our nation in a special way. Oh God, our leaders, we lift up our leaders, God, before you. We pray for President Excellency Paula May Weeks. We pray for Prime Minister, the Honorable Dr. Keith Rowley. We pray for the Honorable Kamala Prasad Bisesa. We pray for each and every member of Parliament right now. God, preserve them, protect them, keep them. God, save them. As they sit to deliberate, oh God, help them to make laws that would benefit Trinidad and Tobago. Good laws, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Minister in a special way unto our commissioner of police, Gary Griffith. Give him wisdom. Give him the strength to execute his duties with excellence, Almighty God. Minister unto our minister of health. Give him the wisdom. Give him the understanding. Be with him at this point in time as we navigate through this pandemic, oh God. Be with our leaders. Be with us in this island of Trinidad and Tobago. Give us your peace. Provide, oh God, for those who need right now. In the name of Jesus, be glorified in today's service. In Jesus' name, and we thank you for doing it. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord. At this time, we would like to welcome our worship team. I encourage you to join in as we worship.
Oh, glory and power, you are the one and only true God. And we come to give you praise, dear Father God. You who was and is to come. You are forever God. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Blessing and honor, glory and power be unto the Ancient of Days. From every nation, all of creation, bow before the Ancient of Days. Every tongue in heaven and earth shall declare your glory. Every knee shall bow at your throne. In worship you would be exalted, O God, and your kingdom shall not pass away, O Ancient of Days. Blessing and honor, blessing and honor, glory and power be unto the Ancient of Days. From every nation, all of creation, bow before the Ancient of Days. Every tongue in heaven and earth shall declare your glory. Every knee shall bow at your throne. In worship you will be exalted, O God, and your kingdom shall not pass away, O Ancient of Days. Your kingdom shall reign over all the earth. Sing unto the Ancient of Days, for none can compare to your matchless word. Sing unto the Ancient of Days. Your kingdom shall reign over all the earth. Oh, sing unto the Ancient of Days, for none can compare to your matchless word. Sing unto the Ancient of Days. Every tongue in heaven and earth shall declare your glory. Every knee shall bow at your throne. In worship you will be exalted, O God, and your kingdom shall not pass away, O Ancient of Days. Your kingdom shall reign over all the earth. Sing unto the Ancient of Days, for none can compare to your matchless word. Sing unto the Ancient of Days. Your kingdom shall reign over all the earth. Sing unto the Ancient of Days, for none can compare to your matchless word. Sing unto the Ancient of Days. Your kingdom shall reign over all the earth. Sing unto the Ancient of Days, for none shall matchless worth. Sing unto the Ancient of Days. Every tongue in heaven and earth shall declare your glory. Every knee shall bow at your throne. In worship you will be exalted, O God, and your kingdom shall not pass away, O Ancient of Days. O Ancient of Days. O Ancient of Days. O Ancient of Days. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
None can compare. Hallelujah. None can compare. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And our God is praise not dead. He's alive. That's why none can compare praise to him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We praise your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Dead. Praise God, he is not dead. My God, he is not dead. Your God, he is not dead. Our God, he is not dead. Praise God, he is not dead. My God,
he is not dead.
Your God,
he is not dead.
Our God,
he is not dead.
Praise God,
he is not dead.
My God, he is not dead. Your God, he is not dead. Our God, he is not dead. Praise God, he is not dead. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah, Lord.
Oh, God.
We praise you, Jesus.
You're not dead. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You have been Hallelujah. So good there, Father God. You have
we
been so good, God. And we just give Hallelujah. You praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, you are good. Lord, you are good. Hallelujah. Your mercy endureth forever, Father. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. People from every nation and tongue, from generation to generation, we worship you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are. We worship you, we worship you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are. Lord, you are good. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. People, people from every nation and tongue, from generation to generation. We worship you. Every nation and tongue, from generation to generation, we worship you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are. We worship you, we worship you. You are good, you are good, all the time, you are good, all the time, you are good, all the time, you are good, you are good, all the time, all the time. You are good. Hallelujah. Praise your name.
Hallelujah.
Oh, we worship your name.
Hallelujah.
Oh, you are good all the time. In the bad times, in the good times. Even when we don't want to go through what we are going through, God, you are still good. You are faithful, God. You are faithful. Hallelujah. My God, my warrior.
Hallelujah.
Ah, the fighter of my battles.
Jesus.
My very present help in time of trouble. Oh, Jesus. Oh, God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Jesus. Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name.
Jehovah is your name.
Jehovah is your name. Mighty warrior, great in battle, Jehovah is your name. Only
before you, God.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
At this time, we would like to have the ministry of the word by our pastor, the Reverend Dr. Melch Pope.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Blessed be the wonderful name of Jesus the Christ, the one who's come to give us life and this life more abundantly. He's come to dwell in us by his Spirit. Praise be unto God, Christ in us, the hope of glory. A pleasant good day to you and greetings in the wonderful name of Jesus the Christ. It is always a joy and privilege for me to deliver God's precious word. Hallelujah, because it brings change. And that's what we need in order to continue to connect as we commit and as we enjoy communing with him. The Bible tells us in the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy, and at his right hand there are pleasures forevermore. Thank you for coming in, for being a part. Thank you for liking this page and just inviting others. I know that God will do a work in you and through you. Hallelujah. Bless his holy name. I want to continue today, of course, in Romans the 8th chapter. So, Brother Sheldon, I want to thank you for the word today, the reading of the scriptures. As we are on empowered by his Spirit, he empowers us both to will and to do of his good pleasure. So thank you, Father, today for the opportunity again to get into your word. Your word is indeed quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword. Oh my, how we love you, Lord. May we be drawn closer to you today. And that change will occur, causing us to fulfill your purpose for our lives. In the name of Jesus the Christ, blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. I want to just read 3 verses to help to strengthen what I believe God wants us to hear today. It's taken from 1 Corinthians, the 6th chapter, from the 9th verse unto the 11th. And the word of God reads thus: Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God. Verse 11, and such were some of you, some of us, but ye are washed, but ye are sanctified, but ye are justified in the name of our Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of our God. We are empowered by His Spirit, growing to greatness, seeking to allow God's Spirit to work in us and through us so that we can bring about change wherever we go. Remember, Jesus said, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe what things soever or all things I have commanded you. Yes, and lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the age. We continue to show how God by His Spirit uses or works to bring it to pass in our lives. And I want to zero in on that word sanctification and justification. And we want to compare and contrast our new life in Christ. How do we manifest this grace that is given unto us? So we're looking at a contrasting, comparing and contrasting justification and sanctification. Remember 1 Corinthians 1:30, I alluded to that a couple weeks ago, but of Him are we in Christ Jesus, who of God is made unto us wisdom and sanctification and redemption and righteousness, so that when we are glorying, it must be in the Lord. So justification, according to 1 Corinthians, or rather Romans chapter 5 and verse 1, therefore being justified by faith, we have peace with God. Sanctification, Romans chapter 8 and verse 1. There is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit, allowing the Spirit of God to work in us and through us. This is where the victory lies, brethren, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. So let's contrast them and compare them. Justification is an act, the act of God declaring the sinner righteous in His sight because we trust the Lord Jesus Christ. Whereas sanctification is a work, the work of God in us by His Holy Spirit. So justification is an act, whereas sanctification is a work. Justification is the means, whereas sanctification is the end. Justifications. Look at Romans chapter 8 and verse number 33. Praise God. Romans 8 and verse number 33. Here's what it says here. Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. Justification is the means. Sanctification is the end. 1 Thessalonians 5:23. And the very God of peace sanctify us fully. And I pray, God, that your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless until Jesus Christ returns. Justification, thirdly, justification is for us. Sanctification is in us. Yes, Romans chapter 8 and verse number 30. Moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called, and whom he called, them he also justified, and whom he justified, them he also glorified. So we're looking at it there. Justification is an act. Justification is the means. Justification is for us. Sanctification is a work. Sanctification is the end. Sanctification is in us. Praise God. Justification declares the sinner righteous. This is what justification does. The act of God working in us. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new. We have received God's righteousness. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse number 21. God made Jesus Christ to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. Justification declares the sinner righteous. Sanctification makes the sinner righteous. Glory be to God. Sanctification, because it is a work in us by the Holy Spirit. So, what happens? Sanctification, we ought to be changed. We ought to be growing. We are changed from glory unto glory, even as by His Spirit. Hallelujah. So, this should realize in us a greater time in His presence. Apart from longing to be in His presence, when we do not, we should be feeling guilty because of the work of the Holy Spirit. Oh, yes. I should desire more and more of God's word because it is He working in me, both to will and to do of His good pleasure. So sanctification makes us righteous because of His work in us. 1 Corinthians 1 and 30. He, Christ, has become our wisdom, our sanctification, our righteousness, our redemption. You see, are you beholding the fact that there's nothing that we could boast about save in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ? Oh, yes, I am crucified with Christ. That's how we ought to see ourselves. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ lives in me. Praise God. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. So I bask in his grace and in his glory, hallelujah, because of what he has done for me. Justification removes the guilt and penalty of sin. And we're going to be dealing with this a little later, expanding on it a little later. Justification removes the guilt and the penalty of sin. Matthew chapter 1 and verse number 21. His name shall be called Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Sanctification removes the growth and the power of sin, whereas justification removes the guilt and the penalty of sin. So we can come boldly to the throne of grace and thereby obtain mercy, so that we can extend this mercy unto others. It's not for ourselves. You see, the more we behold ourselves in the sight of God, in the presence of God, and allowing the Holy Spirit to reveal the things that are not pleasing to God, it is the more we would extend mercy and grace to others. Because the Holy Spirit is there to search us and to expose certain things in our lives that are not pleasing to God. The intention being that at the end of the day, we will be conformed to the image of his Son, Jesus the Christ. Romans chapter 8 and verse number 29. Sanctification is about making us and causing us to draw near to God, drawing near with a true heart in full assurance of faith and confidence. Hallelujah. Understanding that the guilt, yes, and the power of sin is now broken. Hallelujah. Blessed be his glorious name forever and ever. So what do we find? Justification, whereas it has to do with the act of God that declares us righteous. So in other words, if you were saved, if you received, you repented of your sins 40 years ago, you are not more justified today than you were 40 years ago. Because you see, it's an act of God. He does it. He declares us righteous. Amen. Doesn't take it away. But the process, sanctification, is seeking to bring us up to the standard of what God says we are. We are the righteousness of God in him. How does that come into play? But I'm not seeing it in my life, you may say. It is the work of the Holy Spirit in us. He works in us to will and to do of his good pleasure. So sanctification has to do with what? A separation from and devotion to. Separating from sin. Separating ourselves from sin unto salvation. Separating ourselves from works to understanding and receiving the grace of God. Paul says in our separation from sin unto salvation in Romans, the first chapter and the 16th verse, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone who believes." Hallelujah. "For therein is the righteousness of God from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith." So as we live, we ought to be growing. As we grow, we continue to live. You see, there is no neutral point in our relationship with God. It's either we are growing or we are going. It's either we are proceeding, pursuing, or we are receding, and we do not want to recede. These are days in which our world is calling on us. They want to hear the voice of God. And we've got to be in that place where we will hear from Him. It is deliverance or separated, being separated from works unto grace. Here is what Ephesians 2, 8 to 10 tells us. "For by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast." You see, works glorifies man, us. We feel good. We tap ourselves on the shoulder. But grace glorifies God. That's the thing. The grace of God that brings salvation has appeared unto us. Titus 2:11. Teaching us. Making this grace available. Causing us to understand. We are commended to His word and to His grace. Acts 20:32. So that we can live lives pleasing to Him. Not of works, lest any man should boast. Ephesians 2:8 and 9. But then it goes on to verse 10. "For we are His workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, that we should walk in them." We should live. He has already made available the good works so that we can live. We can serve Him in spirit and in truth. Sanctification. Yes, separated from sin unto salvation, from works unto grace, from heaven, from hell rather, unto heaven. That's right. John chapter 5 and verse number 24. "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believeth on him that sent me hath everlasting life and shall not come into condemnation, but is moved, is changed, is conferred, is put over from death unto life." So Romans 8 and 1 is so pertinent again. "There is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. He sanctified me. So are we seeing now? Hebrews 12:14, follow peace with all men and holiness, or the sanctification, the fact that we are separated from that which is not pleasing to God and devoted to that which is pleasing to Him. He's saying today, I am Spirit, and if you're going to worship me, it must be done in spirit and in truth. So, Colossians 3 reminds us, Colossians 3:1, if ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sits at the right hand of the Father. Set our affections on things above and not on things on the earth. For we are dead, and our lives are hidden with Christ in God. Hallelujah. The sanctifying process, causing us to become heirs and joint heirs with Jesus Christ. Yes, whatever the challenges are, we were, but now we are washed. We are sanctified. We are justified by the Spirit of God. Will you receive what He has so graciously given to us and live in it, live in that realm, so we can experience His truth? For the kingdom of God is not in meat and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. Praise God. So, Father, now, how we thank you and we bless you for that sanctifying work of the Holy Spirit in our hearts and in our lives. Lord, we present ourselves to you today. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and see if there be any wicked way in me. And O God, being able to see and understand how you speak to me, I submit to you. I surrender to your Lordship. In the name of Jesus the Christ, I draw closer to you. I ask for your forgiveness. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, where we have taken things for granted, may we submit to your leading. In the name of Jesus the Christ, those of us who continue to have challenges in our lives, oh God, ah God, the sins of the flesh, we mentioned some this day. We ask in the name of Jesus the Christ, knowing that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God, But God, every believer, we're not there. We used to do it. We used to fornicate. We used to be in adultery. We used to be idolaters. We used to be extortioners. But now, thank God for His grace. I pray, Lord, that we would appropriate and walk in that realm. The law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus, having made us free from the law of sin and death. And now I thank you and bless you for setting us free. For if the Son therefore has made us free, we are free indeed. So no more are we going to be living guilty lives. That has been taken care of in Jesus Christ. We bless you and praise you, Father. In the name of Jesus the Christ, blessed be His wonderful name. And Father, I pray for those of us who are experiencing pains, infirmities, oh God, in our bodies, sicknesses. Thank you for Jesus who came, paid the price. He bore our sicknesses and our diseases. He is our Jehovah Rapha, the God who heals. In the name of Jesus the Christ, I speak the healing power of God into our lives. From the crown of our heads to the soles of our feet. Hallelujah. I curse lumps and tumors and cancers in the name of Jesus the Christ. I pray for your covering, Father, your protection and preservation upon us. In the name of Jesus the Christ, thank you for shielding us. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. And what about you today? You have never trusted Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord. Or maybe you're walking afar off. You once served Him. But you're saying, it is time for me to come back home. Yes, it is. Jesus said, except we repent, we shall all likewise perish. Let's come out from there and come back to Him. I want to lead you in a simple prayer today. If you would say after me, please, Lord Jesus, I come to you just as I am, a sinner. I need you. Forgive me now of all my sins. Wash me in your precious blood, Jesus. Come into my life now and save me. I now confess you as my Savior and as my Lord. And I believe in my heart that you are alive and alive forevermore. So thank you for writing my name in your book of life. Amen. Well, that's a simple prayer. So welcome to the family of God. Yes. Amen. The joy of the Lord be your strength. Thank you, Father, for your mercy and your grace. Bless His name. I want you please to call. We want to help you. So important. Bless his holy name. Well, I want to thank you again. I want to thank you for your ongoing financial support. This is important. Remember, the Bible says we need to bring our tithes and offerings into the storehouse. The kingdom of God continues. We need to continue to get the word of God out more than ever before. Thank you. There's some of you, maybe you're not members, but you're part of the body of Christ. Or maybe you're just about wanting to give for the advancement of the kingdom of God. You can call any one of those numbers. We've got a number there that you can go online, make a contribution. The Lord bless you in advance. Hallelujah. As we continue to do his will on the earth, let's fulfill purpose. Hallelujah. So until we meet again, remember, we shall prevail. We are not going under. We are more than conquerors. Why? Because Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The Lord richly bless you and your household. Stay safe and stay blessed. Amen and amen.
Thank you, Pastor, for the ministry of the word, and thank you, viewers. If you have been blessed by this ministry, we encourage you to like, to share, to subscribe to our various social media platforms. Please note that our offices are open on Monday and Friday from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Also, if you would like to support us financially, our account information is listed below. Be safe, stay blessed. We will see you again next week.
Show me your face. Fill up this space. My world needs you right now. My world needs you.